On the line is Comlec Chairman Sixto Brilliantes. Good afternoon, Chairman.
Yes, good afternoon, Coco.
Good afternoon, Chairman. Chairman, you're in the thick of election preparations right now. How much time do you have to be able to settle these this disqualification issues with these partyless groups, Chairman?
Which are the partyless cases?
Yes, sir.
Come from the Supreme Court?
Yes, sir.
I was just going over it when Boris had the copy. It will not be very difficult, really. We'll start by the 16th. We should be able to finish it by the end of the month. There are only 41 parties involved in the decision. And I think by going over it initially, we should be able to settle immediately about almost over one half of that. And then we just have to hit about 20. I think based on the decision set, about 20 of them will already qualify. And the rest will need a little hearing, so we should be able to finish it before the end of the month, or at least at the first week of May.
So did you say, Chairman, that of the 41, you expect that 20 might now qualify?
About at this time, no. 20 would be humming. The 20 would qualify, more or less, under the guidelines, the new guidelines set by the Supreme Court. What we want to do is that anyway, it is already definitely it will not exceed the 123 that we have printed in the ballot. So 41 of them with the SQA, with the status quo ante order, this is what we're going to review. Initially, we're trying to review now with my panel of lawyers. Initially, our review would show that about 20 would already qualify based on the guidelines of the Supreme Court. The remaining ones, this will probably be said by us to listen to some qualification required, after which we should be able to settle this order by the end of the first week of May. Anyway, as long as we come out before the election date, there will be no problem because all of these 41 are already in the ballot. They are already printed in the ballot.
I'm just going to hazard this question, Chairman. Off the top of your head, can you recall any of the 20 that you think might now be qualified based on these new guidelines?
No. So there is really no, there would be no need for any further hearing. I will just have to check whether they have five nominees, in which case if there are two nominees would exceed two of them that qualify, then they would still qualify. Otherwise, if they go less than five, they might be disqualified. But this one we can redo. And there is no need of hearing. We are more worried about the requirement for a summary proceedings, which will take some time. But 15 days would be good enough. If it's about 20, we'll be able to finish twice, two a day. I think we'll be able to finish it all.
Those partyless groups that will remain disqualified, will they still have a chance or do they still have the right to go back to the Supreme Court?
Well, they will most probably, but I don't think the Supreme Court will have time anymore to entertain it, especially if we come out with decisions quite late. To be fair to them, we will probably finish it by the end of the month, as I said. And then they will have another about 10 days when this ready to the Supreme Court. And the Supreme Court issues another status quo, and they will be able to participate. Anyway, as I said, more important is that all their names are already in the ballot, so votes will either be counted or not counted, depending on the final ruling of the Supreme Court, if they go back to the Supreme Court.
Chairman Brilliantes, thank you very much for your time this afternoon.
Okay, Coco.
Thanks a lot. That's your news now. Visit our website, ancnews.tv. Follow ANC Alerts on Twitter and on YouTube. And be a fan of ANC 24/7 on Facebook. We're going to be back with more news at 3. Keep it here on ANC.